just the shape of Chile, geographically, I mean, it's a long country all the way across the western side of South America, running from almost up at the top all the way down to the bottom, so close to Antarctica down at the bottom. Just amazing. I've always wanted to go there. I know a lot of patriots, you know, folks like Dave Von Kleist and others have moved down there, and I've thought about... when I've been looking at areas in the world, it's one of the safer places in South America if you go to the countryside. It's very beautiful, nice people. I mean, if they start arresting everybody and putting everybody in death camps, and if I can get my family out, I will, but it'll just be out of the fire into the frying pan. But a lot of elitists are moving to Chile, and they're pulling out of Costa Rica and Central America. What do you make of that overall, Matias Rojas, the great patriot who confronted David Rockefeller so handily?
I think that we have to let known to these people that they are not safe anywhere, these elitists.
What? I mean, just let them know that we're fully aware of their activities.
Yes, yes. I wanted to make that I wanted to let known to Mr. Rockefeller that we are not his slaves. I mean, they have done an incredible job destroying the values, the family system, everything across the world. I want the people of Chile also to know that they need to find out about this man. CNN even covered the video of my confrontation. The media are now asking, why is this guy, David Rockefeller, meeting with Agustin Edwards here in Chile? We know that at least Sebastián Piñera, who is the current president of Chile, called for a world government, literally a world government, during meeting EPIC last year. And we know that vaccines are damaging little kids. Here we had a little case of a little child called Max from Talca in the south of Chile, who was paralyzed by the H1N1 flu shot.
So it sounds like folks are waking up in Chile, but yeah, your politicians are just flaunting it in your face. Are folks aware in Chile that David Rockefeller, over Kissinger, was involved in honchoing some of the Pinochet activities?
Yes, yes, they're very involved in that. There's a lot of documentaries made in Chile about that, about what happened, but they are still trapped by the left-right paradigm. I uploaded this video, and they say that, oh, I am a communist because this takeover of Chile was right-wing. Well, I will say to them that Rockefeller was also involved praising Mao or praising Fidel Castro in Cuba.
They play both sides of the authoritarian right and left, and they try to keep us frozen in that.
Yes. Well, Rockefeller was also involved giving rewards to Ricardo Lagos, a former Chilean president, who was called, who has called for world governance to fight a global warming. You can find his videos. He was a special envoy from the United Nations to South America about this, previous to Copenhagen, the meeting. In Chile, we have something called Council of Americas, of the Americas, that's derived from the Council on Foreign Relations and the Trilateral Commission, and was founded by David Rockefeller.
It's he's founded more than 60 globalist groups, and they like praise him at the UN and admit he's the one single-handedly, you know, if you had to pick one person who's been at the center of the traveling the world to set up this world government and praising Mao, the biggest mass murderer in history. Matias Rojas, I was going to take off this Friday and take my children camping. Then I got a call from Ron Paul, and he's able to come on Friday, so I'm going to go ahead and do the show Friday, at least the first hour, if we nail that down. Paul Watson was going to be sitting in. I'd like to invite you to stay on the line, and if you can, maybe come on for 30 minutes with Paul Watson on Friday. Joel Skousen's also set. So it's going to be Alex Jones, Paul Watson, Joel Skousen. I'd like to give you 30 minutes more. We'd like to hear from you with your great knowledge about what's happening in South America, in beautiful Chile. But we salute you, Mr. Rojas, from the bottom of my heart. Thank you for defending liberty and humanity. God bless you. What a great man we all can...